we can go into the heart and put in a replacement valve and it can function just like the native heart. And we can also study the flow, we can instrument it so we know exactly how we're affecting the hemodynamics and how we're affecting the motion. And that's all due to recent advancements in imaging and in miniaturization of devices, in materials, in testing. And so from the technology standpoint, I think if we can leverage all that and lead to somebody else starting a lab and doing other great stuff, then that's why we do it. My name is Ellen Roche. I'm an associate professor here at IMES, the Institute for Medical Engineering and Science, and in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. And then I teach at the Harvard Medical School. IMES is an institute that brings together a number of faculty and scientists that are working on medical engineering and science. It's the home of the HST program, where engineering PhD students are co-taught with medical students here at MIT, but also at Harvard Medical School. My research is on medical device design. I did go to medical school, but I was always interested in making stuff and being an engineer. The medical school was more to be able to fully understand the clinical problem, communicate better with the clinicians and the surgeons that would be using these devices. In the Department of Mechanical Engineering, I co-instruct 275, which is medical device design, with Professor Alex Slocum and Professor Giovanni Traverso and Dr. Nevin Hanumara for typically senior undergraduates and also for graduate students. It's a team-based design class, so we come up with clinical needs and the students select which they'd like to focus on. In normal times, we have a in-person prototyping in labs where they build the prototypes together, and at the end of the class we have a gathering where we demo the prototypes and we invite clinicians, people from industry. And this year was kind of a hybrid model where any students that were on campus could meet up, but some of the team was remote. And they did great. They ended up really working well and dividing up the responsibilities for the design project based on who was in person. And then the people that were remote would focus on the analysis, the spreadsheets to do all the calculations. They would be modeling parts and sending them to another student who would go to the machine shop or the hobby shop and get it printed. You know, they have these Google Docs going and they're all typing at the same time, but somehow magically it's like all coming together and it's amazing to watch. I learned so much from them. Before I had kids, I would be thinking back to when I was a student, and now I find myself thinking forward to like, oh, this is going to be the girls soon, and it's a very different emotional kind of attachment to how these students feel. I just was really conscious that I didn't want to make their lives harder than it already was, but like give them something kind of good to grasp onto amidst everything else that was coming. I love teaching here at MIT, and I wouldn't be where I am without people that mentored me and pointed me in the right direction, and so it's very important for me to also do that for my students and trainees, and that they can pursue their dreams too.